Question number 17 asks us to use a ruler to determine the slope of the roof shown below. It asks us to use a ruler because here it says the diagram is drawn to scale. Unless it says that it is to scale, we have to assume that it is not, and therefore you cannot use a ruler. But this one, we're okay, and it tells us to, in fact. So, how would I find the slope of this roof? Well, I have to remember that the slope is rise over run. That is actually on the formula sheet as well, so you really don't need to remember, you just know where to look to find it. So where can I find the rise and the run of this roof on this diagram? Well, if we're talking about a roof, we need to take the rise and run between the lowest point on the roof and the highest point on the roof. So I'm going to use those two there. I could equally have used one on the other side, but I'm just going to use these ones over here. So the rise is the difference in height between them. If I were to measure vertically between them, that's going to be my rise, because this point down here is at the same height as the left-hand point there. And the run is going to be the horizontal distance between them. So that's going to be the run there. I do not want to measure the run as the entire way across this roof, because it goes up and then back down. And so that will give me an inaccurate slope if I try and do that. So even without a ruler here, I can see that the rise is a little bit less than the run, and that they're fairly close to each other. So right away I can rule out answer A, 3 over 8, because the run isn't over double the rise, right? I don't nearly have 8 to 3 here, so I'm going to get rid of that one. And answer D is telling me that the rise of 4 is bigger than the run of 3, and that's not correct either. So now it's just whether it's 3 over 4 or 4 over 5. I don't have a ruler on my computer here, but if you go to the data pages, I'm just going to scroll down here and find them. The data pages that come with the provincial exam include all the unit conversions, formulas, etc. And if you go to the last one there, where it's called the geometry formulas, you see there's also a metric ruler here. And so what I would do is actually rip that page off and use that ruler back up there for question number 17 to see if we can measure this roof here, this rise and this run. And if you pull that out and measure it, you should get an answer of B, 3 over 4. So I'm not sure what the rise is going to measure or what the run is going to measure, but if you take the measurement for the rise and divide it by the run, and you reduce that fraction, you should get 3 over 4.